Good morning, students. This is another class on non-conventional energy sources. Today we are going to study solar collectors, which is basically a major component of any solar system. We define solar collectors as a device that absorbs the incoming solar radiations and converts it into heat, which is then transformed into a fluid. Solar collectors are basically two types, non-concentrating and concentrating. In the non-concentrating type of solar collector, the collector area, that is the area that intercepts the solar radiation, is same as the observer area. Observer area is basically the area absorbing the radiations. Because collector area is same as absorber area, hence we say that in this type, the whole solar panel absorbs the light. Whereas in concentrating type of solar collector, they have bigger collector area as compared to absorber area. Concentrating collectors are basically more complex structures. When we talk of domestic or industrial water heating, then solar thermal collectors can be further classified based upon the shape of the collectors into two types. Either they are flat plate or they are evacuated type of solar collectors. In flat plate solar collectors, as we can see from the figure, it is the most common type of solar collector which is used for domestic household purposes such as water heating, space heating, where the demand temperature is low. Flat plate collector is basically a black surface that is placed at the convenient path of the sunlight so as to absorb maximum sunlight and to receive the maximum sun rays at an optimum position. In the other type, evacuated tube collectors, they are built to reduce the heat conduction losses. They consist of two glass tubes, as we can see in the figure. The outer tube is made of extremely strong transparent glass that is able to withstand changing climatic conditions, while the inner tube is made of a glass but coated with a special coating which features excellent solar heat absorption qualities. Solar furnace is another device or a structure that we can discuss, which basically uses a concentrated type of solar power to produce high temperature and especially used for industrial applications. There are many types of solar furnaces and each produce different power. The best known solar furnace is called as a high flux solar furnace. In this, one flat mirror or heliostat that is very large in size and tracks the sun to ensure greatest reflection of sunlight into the primary concentrator is used. We can see from here that it is using a concentrating mirror, a solar furnace and a heliostat. From the previous figure, we say that the light from the concentrator is focused on a circle or target inside the furnace. The focused beam of light created by the concentrator is much, much stronger than the normal sunlight. Temperatures rise in solar furnace greater than 1832 Fahrenheit per second. The power level inside the furnace is also adjustable by a device which is called as an attenuator. These solar furnaces are primarily used for generating heat or steam so as to make electricity for industrial use. Steam created by solar furnaces can be further used to run generators and other industrial equipment. An advantage of using solar created heat in such system is that the heat is clean and without any harmful emissions. So this is all for the solar collectors. In the next class, we will further go into the detail of the types and their applications of solar collectors and the commonly used devices that are used for generating electricity at domestic as well as commercial application purposes. Thank you.